today's social class with your social teacher Sulakshana from East Madhapur. Children, all of you like playing? Yes? Yes. What type of games do you like? Indoor or outdoor? Yes, you all like mostly the outdoor games like cricket, hide and seek, coco. Yes. With whom you are going to play this? Yes, with the friends. Where are your friends? At home, your neighbors. Mostly with your neighbors. And in the school, you will be playing with your classmates during the games period. Yes, as you grow up, children, you will be concentrating more on your studies and your career, and you will be settling in different regions. In the same way, I used to have good friends, my best friends, and they both got settled in USA and Australia. And children, where do you think is this Australia and USA? Yes, they are on the earth. And they are they both together at one place? No. Each Australia is at one place and USA at one place. And in which country we are living, children? Yes, it's India. And India is a part of Asia continent. So Australia, USA, India, they are all a part of the earth. So this is the world which we are living in. So the topic for today is the world we live in. The world we live in. Children, as we have discussed that we live on the earth and it is a world. And what is that that supports life on the earth? It's the land, water, air, sunlight, this all which supports the life on the earth. And during the earlier times, olden days, the people used to think that the earth was flat and if we walk from this end to that end, we will fall. Even children, when you stand on the seashore and if you see at the ships which are sailing in the sea, after some time the ships disappear and you see that the sky and the sea seem to meet, they appear to meet. Do they really meet? No, it's our imagination, because our eyesight is limited to a particular distance and we imagine that the sky and the earth or the sea appear to meet. And the point where the sky and the earth appear to meet, it is known as horizon. Even one more example I would like to give you, children. Like if you go to the terrace of the building and if you see at the sky, after a certain distance, you feel or you imagine that the sky and the earth both meet. But do they really meet? No, it's an imagination. So the point at which the sky and the earth appear to meet, it is known as horizon. And when we see this horizon, we feel that the earth is flat. Yes, but one of the explorers named Ferdinand Magellan. Explorer is a person who finds new places. So, Ferdinand Magellan, in the year 1519, he went on a voyage. Voyage is a journey through a ship. He went on a voyage around the earth and he circumnavigated around the earth. Circumnavigate means to complete one complete round around the earth. And he has proved that the earth is round. And the astronauts have taken the pictures from the space, which shows that the earth is like a sphere. The earth is like a sphere. But can we see the curving surface of the earth, children? No, because the earth is very big and we are living in it. So we can't see the curving surface. If we have to see the curving surface, we have to go into the space. Okay, and if we go in a spacecraft, then only we can see the earth from the space, where we can have a clear idea of the shape of the earth. And as I said, the shape of the earth is sphere. Sphere, a thing that is round in shape like a ball. But the scientists have proved, the scientists have noticed that the earth is not exactly like a sphere. At both the ends, it is little bit flattened. It is little bit flattened and it is bulged in the middle. It is bulged in the middle. So here, On the earth, we can find two main features, children. Land and water. The earth is covered with land and water. The land. The large pieces of land on the earth, they are known as the continents. And the large water bodies on the earth, they are known as the oceans. Now we will learn about the continents and oceans. Children, on the earth we have seven continents. As we have already learned in our third class, there are seven continents on the earth. The first largest continent is Asia. Asia is the largest continent and it is the most populous continent in the world. Populous means having more number of people. And India is a part of the continent of Asia. Second largest continent is Africa. Africa is the second largest continent and the world's largest desert, the Sahara Desert, lies in this continent. The third largest continent is North America. And America was discovered by one more explorer named Christopher Columbus. And it has very well developed countries like USA, Mexico and Canada. The fourth largest continent is South America. And this North America and South America, they both are joined, connected with a narrow strip of land known as Isthmus of Panama. Isthmus is a narrow strip of land connecting two large masses of land. The fifth largest continent is Antarctica. It is also known as a white continent because it is always covered with the snow and ice. And there is no human life on this continent of Antarctica. And here only we can find the animal life like penguins, seals, etc. And the sixth largest continent is Europe. Right next to Asia, we have the continent of Europe. And this Europe is also having very well developed countries. The smallest continent among the seven continents is Australia. The word Australia, it has been taken from a Latin word austral, which means south. And this is also known as an island continent because it is surrounded on all the sides with water. So, a piece of land surrounded all the sides with water, it is known as island. So, this continent, it is covered with water on all the sides. That's why it is known as island continent. So children, an easy way to remember this continent is, here is a mnemonic through which we can remember the continents, seven continents easily. Look at this children. Always an apple says a nurse. Always eat an apple says a nurse. Here's children, the first letter A. Africa, it resembles Africa. E, Europe. A in an, Antarctica. A, Asia. S, South America. A, Australia. And N, North America. It is a mnemonic which helps us to remember all the seven continents easily. So, repeat after me children. Always eat an apple says a nurse. This is very easy way to remember all the seven continents. Now we will be learning about the oceans. The large water bodies on the earth, they are known as the oceans. Oceans are the deepest water bodies on the earth. And here we have five oceans on the earth. The first largest ocean is Pacific Ocean. Second largest is the Atlantic Ocean. The third largest is the Indian Ocean. The fourth largest is the Southern Ocean. And the smallest ocean is the Arctic Ocean. Children, these are the five oceans on the earth. And the other water bodies which are smaller than the oceans, they are known as the seas. And all these oceans are a part of the same continuous water body, salt water bodies. And there is an acronym which helps us to remember these five oceans. Here is the acronym, children, PAISA. What is it? PAISA. 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 P for Pacific, A for Atlantic, I for Indian, S for Southern, and A for Arctic. These are the five oceans which can be easily represented with an acronym PAISA. Repeat after me, children. PAISA. P for Pacific, A for Atlantic, I for Indian, S for Southern, and A for Arctic. Yes. Now, children, we will be learning about the another topic, another content. Like, children, we have learned about oceans, continents which are there on the earth. Now, if we want to know more about the earth, if we want to study the earth, how we can? Can you tell me? Yes, very good. With the help of a globe. Is there any other thing other than the globe which help us to study the earth? Yes, it's the map. Now we will learn about the globe. Children, look at this. This is the globe. Globe is a small model of the earth. The earth is very big that we cannot study it. So, geographers are the people who are experts in the study of the physical features of the earth. So, they have made it easier by representing the whole earth on the globe is a globe. And this globe, it shows exactly the same features as the earth, like the continents, oceans, and countries. And it is exactly the shape of the earth, and it shows each and every physical feature in the correct size. On a smaller scale, the earth is reduced so many times and it is made on a smaller scale, which is the globe. Like shape and map is a, children see here, globe, a model of the earth. Whereas map is a drawing of the earth or places on the earth on a flat surface. We all know maps are flat, children. Whereas globe is spherical. But here there is a small difference in the globe and map. Like globe shows the features like continents, oceans, and countries. But the map, it gives more detailed information compared to the globe. Yes, and see here, children, if we can see at a time only one side of the globe, only one part of the globe we can see at a time. If we have to see the other side, we have to turn it on a line that passes through it. We have to turn it on a line which passes through it. And this imaginary line, this line on which it passes through, is known as axis. What is it known as, children? Axis. See here, axis, an imaginary line that runs through north and south pole along which earth spins. An imaginary line that runs through north pole and south pole around which the earth spins. The earth always rotates, children. So here, the globe, if we have to see the other side of the globe, we have to turn it around the line passing through it. And this line is called the axis. And this axis is, children, it is tilted. Tilted means a little bit sloping. And this tilted position was given to the earth when it was formed. And this tilted position, it has a tilt at an angle of 23.5 degrees. It has a tilt at an angle of 23.5 degrees. As there is an axis for the globe. The earth also has an axis and it rotates around its axis. And the two end points of this axis on which it rotates, they are known as the poles. What these known as, children? They are known as poles. The topmost end is the north pole and the bottom one is the south pole. These two are the poles and this is the axis through which the earth spins. Spinning is rotating on itself, moving on itself. It is known as rotation. And now, children, here you can see the midway between the poles, there is a line running, circling on the earth. And this line, at the midway between the poles, there is a line circling the earth. This line is known as the equator. What is this line known as? Equator. Equator means it divides the earth into two equal halves. So here, children, see, the upper half is known as northern hemisphere and this one is known as a southern hemisphere. What is an hemisphere? Sphere means a thing that is round in shape like a ball. Hemisphere means half of the sphere is known as the hemisphere. So the equator divides the earth into two equal parts. The upper part is northern hemisphere and the other one is the southern hemisphere. And our India, it lies in Asia continent and it is in the northern hemisphere. Children, I hope you have understood all the topics which I have discussed today. Yes, like sphere, globe, map, axis, poles, north pole, south pole, equator, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. And we will be learning about more concepts of this lesson in the next class. Thank you.